Mimi ni mchungaji Caroline Makange.
I'm Pastor Caroline Makange.
Ninawaletea salamu toka usharika wa Marindi.
I bring greetings from Marindi Parish.
Nimezaliwa mwaka 1967.
I was born in 1967.
Nimeolewa na nina watoto sita.
I am married with 6 children.
Nimebarikiwa kuwa mchungaji tarehe 7 mwezi wa pili mwaka 2021.
I was ordained to be pastor on 7th February 2021.
Siku hiyo hiyo nikachaguliwa kuhudumia usharika wa Marindi.
On the same day, I was appointed to serve at Marindi.
Nina furaha kuwa usharika wa Marindi una mahusiano na kanisa la Gloria Dei.
I am happy that Marindi Parish is in companionship with Gloria Dei Lutheran Church.
Tunashukuru kwa misaada mbalimbali kwa usharika wa Marindi.
Thank you for your support in various projects at Marindi.
Tunawakaribisha sana kutembelea usharika wa Marindi.
We warmly welcome you to visit Marindi.
Tunawatakia mafanikio katika Jumapili hii ya mahusiano.
Wish you all the best in our companionship Sunday.
Sisi pia tunaadhimisha Jumapili ya mahusiano.
We also have companionship service today.
Usharika wa Marindi unawaombea hasa kwa janga la COVID-19 na athari zake.
Marindi Parish is praying for you, especially for COVID pandemic on its and its effects in your community.
Tunawaombea amani na baraka za Mungu.
May God's peace and blessings be with you all.
Asanteni.
Thank you.
Good morning. Glad you could gather for worship with us this morning. My name is Travis Borkowski, and I'm honored to cover bases here for Pastor Trish while she's on sabbatical. It's a special Sunday for us in the church here as we celebrate the relationship we have with the companion church in Marindi, and we appreciate the gifts that they have contributed to our space and to our worship. So I'm going to keep it short this morning. There are other things that are more pressing, so I'm going to invite Kevin first. No, Greg, sorry. Greg, come forward for a few brief announcements. Pray up, man.
Good morning. I'm Greg Morningstar. I'm coming here from the worship committee. As many of you know, we are going to have lay-led Lenten services. Pastor Travis will lead us on Ash Wednesday, but the rest of the Wednesday Lenten services will be lay-led. And so we are looking for people who would be willing to do a 5 to 10 minute talk, meditation on, we already have the scripture verses and we have the themes for each week. And then one other person to be the quote-unquote leader, and that all that involves is giving kind of the opening prayer or the closing prayer. So if you are interested in doing that, we have some volunteers already, but if you would be interested in doing that for one of the Wednesday services, please get a hold of me. I'd appreciate it. Thank you.
A little pronunciation guide today. We're going to be using some Swahili in our songs. And you've sung them before, so you may be familiar, but some of you may not be. In the first song, we're singing Imani Moja. In Swahili, I's are said like long E's, E's are said like long A's, and A's are said like ah. So we have Imani Moja, like our banner, one faith, Imani Moja. Pastor Mkatubi brought that white parted banner with him when he visited us several years ago. So that is from Tanzania, as are all the fabrics you're seeing and our artifacts that we have outside in the fellowship hall. In the second song, we had a Zoom call with a couple of our friends from Tanzania a couple weeks ago, and we asked them what song would be good for both of us to sing at our celebration of our partnership. and they said, Asante Sana Yesu. So the last song is Asante Sana Yesu, Asante Sana Yesu, Asante Sana Yesu, Moyo Ni, Moyo Ni.
One more brief announcement. Our announcements for the community of faith are located in the back vault and on the website. If you need them, feel free to reference them. And as we begin worship, I'm going to ask you to shift gears. When you hear the word grace, what comes to mind? Hold on to that image. The other word that I've been thinking about this week is mercy. When you hear the word mercy, what comes to your mind? I invite you to let those two images or definitions, let those be the meditation of your heart as we take a few moments of silence to gather our thoughts, and then we will begin with our confession and forgiveness. Let us begin. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who creates us, redeems us, and calls us by name.
Amen.
Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and in the presence of one another. Most merciful God, we confess
that we have sinned against you and your beloved children.
We have turned our faces away from your glory, when it did not appear as we expected. We have rejected your word when it made us confront ourselves. We have failed to show hospitality to those you called us to love. Accept our repentance for the things we have done and the things we have left undone. For the sake of Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us and lead us, that we may bathe in the glory of your Son, born among us, and reflect your love for all creation. Amen. Rejoice in this good news. In Christ Jesus, your sins are forgiven. You are the descendants of the Most High, adopted into the household of Christ, and inheritors of eternal life. Live as freed and forgiven children of God.
Amen.
Let us pray.
Lord Jesus, make us instruments of your peace, that where there is hatred, we may show love, where there is injury, pardon, and where there is despair, hope. Grant, O divine Master, that we may seek to console, to understand, and to love in your name. For you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
We continue with the reading of our lessons for today.
The first lesson is from the 45th chapter of Genesis. Many years after being sold into slavery by his jealous brother, Joseph reveals himself to them. Genesis chapter 45, verses 3 through 11 and verse 15. Joseph said to his brothers, "I am Joseph. Is my father still alive?" But his brothers could not answer him. So dismayed were they at his presence. Then Joseph said to his brothers, "Come closer to me." And they came closer. He said, "I am your brother, Joseph, whom you sold into Egypt. And now do not be distressed or angry with yourselves because you sold me here, for God sent me before you to preserve life. For the famine has been in the land these 2 years, and there are 5 more years in which there will be neither plowing nor harvest. God sent me before you to preserve for you a remnant on earth and to keep alive for you many survivors. So it was not you who sent me here, but God. He has made me a father to Pharaoh and lord of all his house and ruler over all the land of Egypt. Hurry and go up to my father and say to him, 'Thus says your son Joseph, God has made me lord of all Egypt. Come down to me, do not delay. You shall settle in the land of Goshen and you shall be near me, you and your children and your children's children, as well as your flocks, your herds, and all that you have. I will provide for you there, since there are 5 more years of famine to come, so that you and your household and all that you have will not come to poverty.' And he kissed all his brothers and wept upon them. And after that, his brothers talked with him." This is the word of the Lord. The second lesson is from the 15th chapter of 1 Corinthians. Paul preaches passionately about the mystery of following Christ's perfect life into eternity. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 35 through 38, and verses 42 through 50. "But someone will ask, 'How are the dead raised? With what kind of body do they come?' Fool, what you sow does not come to life unless it dies. And as for what you sow, you do not sow the body that is to be, but a bare seed, perhaps of wheat or of some other grain. But God gives it a body as he has chosen, and to each kind of seed its own body. So it is with the resurrection of the dead. What is sown is perishable. What is raised is imperishable. It is sown in dishonor. It is raised in glory. It is sown in weakness. It is raised in power. It is sown a physical body. It is raised a spiritual body. If there is a physical body, there is also a spiritual body. Thus it is written, 'The first man, Adam, became a living being. The last Adam became a life-giving spirit.' But it is not the spiritual that is first, but the physical, and then the spiritual. The first man was from the earth, a man of dust. The second man is from heaven, and was the man of dust. So are those who are of the dust. And as is the man of heaven, so are those who are of heaven. Just as we have borne the image of the man of dust, we will also bear the image of the man of heaven. What I am saying, brothers and sisters, is this: flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, nor does the perishable inherit the imperishable." This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you. sixth chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said to them, "But I say to you that listen, love your enemies, do good to those who hate you, bless those who curse you, pray for those who abuse you. If anyone strikes you on the cheek, offer the other. And from anyone who takes away your coat, do not withhold even your shirt. Give to everyone who begs from you, and if anyone takes away your goods, do not ask for them again. Do to others as you would have them do to you. If you love those who love you, what credit is that to you? For even sinners love those who love them. If you do good to those who do good to you, what credit is that to you? For even sinners do the same. If you lend to those from whom you hope to receive, what credit is that to you? Even sinners lend to sinners to receive as much again. But love your enemies and do good and lend and expect nothing in return. Your reward will be great and you will be children of the Most High, for he is kind to the ungrateful and the wicked. Be merciful just as your Father is merciful. Do not judge and you will not be judged. Do not condemn and you will not be condemned. Forgive and you will be forgiven. Give and it will be given unto you. A good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, will be put into your lap. For the measure you give will be the measure you get back." The Gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Grace and peace to you from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. It seems to me that Luke has given us a nice big load of ideas to consider when we hear the words of Jesus today. I don't know what I've struggled with more in my preparation this week, reading the text or the message that Jesus is inviting us to embrace. But before we jump into that, I thought it might be interesting to do a little bit of a query or invite a little bit of congregational participation in the sermon today. Are you ready? Remember with me, there's no right or wrong answer. It's about gaining insight and understanding where we are as individuals and where we are as communities of faith. And so, in preparation for the service, I posed two words for you, grace and mercy. I'd like to start with mercy. When you hear the word mercy, what comes to mind? Sitting in silence during the sermon? See? Anyone brave enough to share? Or is mercy one of those things that's hard to explain? Having compassion for the other. I'll take that. Forgiveness is part of mercy. Ah. Acceptance as who you are. Okay. Any other wisdom? I think you've grabbed all facets of mercy. What about grace? When you hear the word grace, what comes to mind? Thankfulness. That's a response to the grace. Okay? Acceptance. The other accepting you for who you are. Okay? Love despite our faults. Faith. Undeserved. Ah. Unconditional. Ah. Okay, so as I've been teasing these words out in my mind, two definitions came to mind. And I heard it presented this way. I do not know where it came from. It's probably been 10 or 15 years since I first heard this way, but they stick with me this morning, and this is it. Mercy, not getting what we deserve. Fair enough. The officer had mercy on me when he pulled me over. Yeah, there's the laugh. Thank you. Have you been there? Have you been other times where have you received mercy? Maybe it's something went wrong at work and your employer said, you can do better. but I'm not going to write you up for it. I've received a lot of mercy in my job. Long story short, I also handle the bereavement side of things, and our bereavement process is a bit different than I would have expected. And I wrestled with that. My boss has been very merciful and compassionate towards me. What about grace? Grace is getting what we don't deserve. There's some grace going on at our house at home. Our house at home this morning. My daughter is having Girl Scout cookies for breakfast. That wasn't my doing either. That's a dad thing. What about you? Do you have a time in your life where that grace was extended to you that sticks out? I've encountered it here with you. As a community of faith, you work to live it out. And as the fill-in pastor going from church to church, everything's a little bit different. And your kindness and your compassion with me is greatly appreciated as we figure out what it means to be the church together. It seems to me, if we boil down the text that we have from Luke today, Jesus is saying, here's the way you live your life, friends. You extend mercy to others, and you extend them grace. And that's a very, very radical idea if you knew the world that Jesus was living in. And I think if we're honest about it, it's not a whole lot different than it is today. I think the one constant theme in the time of Jesus and the time of us is people. And so when Jesus presents these ideas in our text today and invites people to live out of mercy and grace, that challenges the way of the world. It challenges the social order. It challenges the structure. One thing that was very clear in the Roman world is relationships were very dependent on the other. It was very hierarchical, and the person that you're interacting with always has something to offer you, and so your responsibility is to do what the other expects. Jesus comes in, and he says, okay, let's try living out of mercy. Let's try living out of grace and see what that does for the world. But as you can imagine, that idea can be threatening to those who have expectations of you. We are human beings who learn from our experience. Our past shapes the way we live out in the world. If you're living a particular way and someone comes in and invites you to see the world in a different way, that can be uncomfortable. So it's no wonder Jesus kind of got sideways with the wrong people, because this message is so challenging to the way of the world. So, grace and mercy. How's that working for you in your daily life? Seems to me that the Lord gives me plenty of opportunities to live them out. And my struggle is living them out, right? And so our calling as the church is to practice it. And that's what I've encountered here with you as a community of faith. You're working on practicing it, living it out. Are you going to get it right, 100% perfect? Nope. That's where grace shows up. That's where mercy shows up. That's the foundation for the way that we live out our lives in the world. And for me, friends, that's very hopeful that we can come together and do this as the Church of Jesus in the world. A seminary professor that I studied with, his name is Craig Nesson. Craig Nesson talks about in one of his books, I forget which one, I've read a few, I wonder why. Craig talks about in his book the way to look at Sunday morning worship. In the past 75, 100, 150 years, the focus of church has been that we are working to make it to church on Sunday, right? That's the language I've heard with my patients that I've cared for in the end of life. That's the language I've heard with as I've worked in multiple churches. You know, we work all week to get here on Sunday so we can focus. Craig dares to say, what if we got it wrong? What if we think about Sunday morning worship as the place where we gather to practice our core beliefs? And then as the church, we are sent into the world to live those out. As the popular memes on Facebook or wherever would say, when I first heard that, my mind was kapoof. The work that we do as the church are not here within the walls. The work that we do as the church is in the world. So my prayer for you as a community of faith is for you as individuals, for the Marimbi Parish, for all followers of Christ in the world, is that we may be grace-filled and merciful people every day of our lives. That we may share the love and grace and forgiveness that we have received with God with all that we encounter. And that our lives speak to the God who loves us. Let us pray. Most and good and gracious God, we thank you for the gift of your Son, Jesus, who embodies mercy and grace and forgiveness and love and hope and new life. Be with us, your people in this world, that all of those things revealed in Jesus are carried with us into the world, and the world may know your mercy and your grace and your love and your forgiveness through our lives. Strengthen us in all that we do, and bless us for your service. We pray this in the name of our merciful and grace-filled Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Please join me as we confess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Spirit of the Lord is poured out in abundance, so we are bold to pray for the church, the world, and all that God has made. You teach us to love our neighbors and our enemies alike. Encourage your church to follow the leading of your love, especially when it is risky or difficult. Help us to show mercy just as we have first received mercy. Lord, in your mercy. Nurture fields that lie dormant, resting until it is time to bloom again. Bless farmers and all who cultivate fields and urban gardens. Give favorable weather for planting. Bring forth from buried seed an abundant harvest. And guard against famine and disease. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Look upon our world with mercy, that we may delight in an abundance of peace. Protect all whose lives are marred by war and civil unrest. Release political prisoners and amplify the voices that challenge us to seek forgiveness and pursue nonviolence. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Your people cry out for mercy. Console hearts that long for forgiveness. Mend broken relationships. Heal bodies that suffer from chronic pain or illness. Strengthen and deliver all whose spirits are troubled. Lord, in your mercy. You bind us together into one family. Teach us to forgive one another and to resolve conflicts with humility and patience. Bless families of all shapes and sizes, and sow love for those who are lonely or grieving. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We give thanks and ask for blessings for our companion congregation partnership with the Marindi Lutheran Parish in Tanzania. May the Spirit inspire and lead us as we respond to God's call to service and to walk alongside our global companions. We remember Pastor Simeon Michi on the death of his wife, Lightness, on December 31st. We ask that you provide comfort and peace through the promise of resurrection. Lord, in your mercy. We praise you for the saints who have inherited the fullness of your kingdom. As you have raised them to imperishable and eternal life, sustain us in faith by the promise of resurrection. Lord, in your mercy. Since we have such hope in your promises, O God, we lift these and all of our prayers to you in the confidence of our faith. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread. He gave thanks. He broke it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup. He gave thanks. He gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
As you remove the seal over the bread and eat, know that this is the body of Christ given for you. And as you remove the seal over the wine or juice and drink, know that this is the blood of Christ shed for you. Our blessing. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. And let us pray. We give you thanks, gracious God, for we have feasted on the abundance of your house. Send us to bring good news and to proclaim your favor to all. Strengthen with the richness of your grace in your Son, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And receive our Lord's blessing. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord's face shine upon you with grace and be gracious unto you. May the Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And we conclude with our final hymn, Asante Santa Jesu. I invite you to join in and sing the beautiful song.
Thank you.
share the good news.
Thanks be to God.
I invite you to share the peace with one another.